And hi everyone, it's just so good to spend some time with you on this beautiful Saturday afternoon. I hope you're not melting away and disappearing into the asphalt in any way. It's very, very hot out there. So I hope you're nice and comfy and all air conditioned and sit back and relax, and we're going to share a few little things with you this afternoon. Today I'm going to be chatting to you about the power of vision boarding and of course list writing. Now I know quite a number of you have had experiences with me. Maybe you've come along to one of my seminars, or maybe you've had you've been reading my Facebook posts that I put up over the course of time that pertain to the importance of harnessing your energies into a force and into a way that's going to assist you in your pathway of manifesting. Now, when we talk about manifestation, we can manifest so many things in our life. What the universe needs from us is some direction as to how that manifestation can come about. Now, we can manifest things, we can manifest experiences, we can manifest good things, and we can also manifest things that are not so good. So, in a way, if we don't hold our vibration in the correct way, we can actually manifest an illness. You know, it's just so, so powerful. When we talk about the power of universal manifestation, it's just incredible where it can actually go. So, one of the things that I was taught many, many years ago was the power of vision boarding and creating a vision board and also writing your lists. Now, I think I constructed my first vision board probably back in the late 90s. It was something that was very new to me back then. I hadn't heard much about it, and I was involved with another business at that particular point of time, and a lot of the leaders were talking about vision boarding. And of course, I, you know, put my first vision board together. And to my astonishment, pretty much everything on it came to pass within a 3 to 4, maybe 5 year period. And the thing that really struck me back then, I thought, my God, why aren't we being taught this at schools? Why aren't the kids taught all this? Well, we all know the reasons why. There's lots of other reasons why we don't get taught these things. And if we are lucky enough to be exposed to the concept of vision boarding and list writing, it can really change your life, guys. It has changed my life immeasurably. And the journey that I'm going to take you on today is a little bit about the journey that I've been on in a personal way. I'm going to share with you some tips that I believe are very powerful, and they've certainly worked for me. And in a way, it's that beautiful old universal saying, do be careful what you wish for because you'll get it. And I'm also going to share with you the importance of being very specific about what it is that you do request and how you can bring it all about. Now, the beautiful thing is, with vision boarding and with list writing, it works for everybody. This is not something where the universe picks and chooses as to, oh, well, you're lucky and you're not. You'll get what you want, you won't get what you want. There's so much into it. In fact, much more that I can probably go into it in the 1 hour that we've got together this afternoon. But I'm going to give you the nuts and bolts and the basics of, you know, how to construct it all and how to put it all together. Now, with vision boarding, we'll start off with the vision boarding, and I'll share a little bit about my journey with vision boarding, how it's worked for me and what I employ in my own vision boarding techniques and how it all comes together. And then after that, we'll go over into the list writing, and I'll show you how to construct your list to create a powerful formula to manifest that you so desire in your life. Because, my beautiful friends, what I want for you is I wish and dream that every one of you can live your life to the fullest and the grandest and the greatest and manifest your wildest dreams possible. And the thing you've got to get your head around is that it is possible, and it will come to pass. So we're going to kick off with vision boarding first. And for me, vision boarding is, I call it a little bit of a roadmap of our dreams. Now, a lot of people do say to me, David, I don't really need a vision board. I don't have a vision board. I've got my vision all up in my head. I've got all my thoughts in my head, and I can create, you know, my visions that way. Well, that's fair enough. I guess a lot of people carry things in their thoughts. But I feel that when you take something out of your thought and put it onto a board, cardboard, a piece of cardboard, or put it onto even a corkboard, when you start putting your visions down, you start visualizing in the sense of, you know, you can see this on a daily basis. You might have it on the ceiling above your bed, so when you wake up in the morning, the first thing you see is your vision board, your vision dream. I think it was Mike Dooley from The Secret, the movie The Secret. I think he did that. Jack Canfield did that with a, I think it was a $10 million check. He had it on his ceiling, And when he wake up in the morning, bang, there was his little vision board of his $10 million check. He just visualised that he would get this and manifest it into his life. And, of course, guess what? It all came to pass. It did happen, and he created that, as it did with Mike Dooley. So with your vision boarding, a couple of things to be mindful of. A lot of people have a vision board, which is quite okay. But I see some people have got a vision board and they've got all sorts of things crammed on it. They've got cars and holidays and homes and partners and businesses and activities and family stuff. That's good, but it's all on the one. Don't imagine and don't forget that you can have more than one vision board. You can have two or three vision boards if you wish. And of course, obviously, it depends on how much room you've got. Some people don't have a lot of room and space. But I know sometimes you might have a vision board that is strictly for business. You might have one is for relationships. You might have one for travel. You might have one for your family and so forth. So there's no problem with how many vision boards you have. And the thing that you've got to get out of your head, guys, is this thing of being greedy. I know some people say to me, I don't want to be greedy. I don't want to ask for too much. Well, you know, it's funny. You can't really ask for too much, and it's a hard one to quantify because people say, "Oh, but I don't want to ask for too much." What your dream is matters to you, and it may not be monetary. It might be an experience that you wish to have. It might be the best job or the best business that you've been looking for. It can be anything like that. You've got to try to get around the poor mentality of oh my gosh, I can only afford this and I can only afford that. A vision board is about a vision and a dream of that is, I call it the outcome board. I call vision boards a little bit of an outcome board because you should be just focused on the outcome of what you're looking for and not how you're going to get there. How are you going to afford the flash new convertible that you've got on the vision board? How are you going to afford the beautiful, the bigger home? How are you going to afford that luxury holiday? How are you going to afford the private school for your kids? Blah, blah, blah. You've got to take your mind out of the how and just put the vision up there. And part of the surrendering process is giving it over to the universe so that the universe can look after it. Because it's putting up your vision boards, this is what I've done all the way along. I've done probably three or four vision boards over the course of time now. And it's, as I said, they've pretty much always come to pass. So it's been good. But in that whole process, it's just committing to the belief and committing to the outcome. And the most important word I can bring into your vision board is feeling good about that you see. So every time your eyes meet your vision board, you might have it in your bedroom, you might have it in the toilet, you might have it in the lounge room somewhere, you might have it in your office. But when you look at your vision board, connect with it and just call it the knowing. I just know that this is coming to pass. It's coming to pass. I feel it coming to pass. But there's a little bit of conjecture about this, and it's something that I'm quite open about, but I'll explain it to you in detail here. A lot of people have a belief that when you do a vision board, you've got to have a date on it. You've got to have your date. Well, this is what I want to achieve by blah, blah, blah. Personally and respectfully, I don't always employ that adage. It's not something that I really agree with, only because, again, through my own experience, I think it's something that we have to be mindful of, is that what we put out to the universe will come to pass for us in divine time. When things come to pass, it is always in divine time. And once you start to work with divine time and divine energy, that's when things really start to move for you. Because if you are patient, and guess what? We don't have any choice but to be patient, because we don't know when it is our divine timing to receive that we so desire or that we're asking for. So be mindful of that when you do put your vision board together, whatever it is that you put on there, you can put a time frame on there if you like, but don't be committed necessarily to it as in I must have this by then. Because I think what you're in danger of then is if you feel that, well, you've got to have XYZ by Christmas Eve. And if Christmas Eve comes and goes, and you'll just shrug your shoulders and say, oh, well, you know, this SH1T doesn't work. This is all crap. It doesn't work. I'm going to toss the vision board away. Universe could have been just getting close to delivering that you were desiring, and when you pull back, it pulls back as well. It's like, oh, well, if you've given up, we've given up too. So we start to dissipate. And that's when people walk away and say, oh, all that vision boarding stuff is rubbish. It doesn't work. You know, because, you know, I tried that and I wanted the new car or the new home or the new job by Christmas time. No, it didn't happen. So it doesn't really work. We have to be mindful of what that's all about. Anyway, for me, one of the most powerful things you can do is take the time to sit down and think, you know, thoroughly about what you would like and what you would like to bring into your life and what you would like, what you desire. As I said, guys, it may not be a material thing. It may not have a monetary value. You might be desiring a new partner, a new experience. You might like a new job, or it could be a whole mishmash of everything. It could be a little bit of everything. So don't always think that a vision board is something that it has to be monetized in some way or has to all to do with money. Of course, money's all a part of it, but that's just an energy. And here's another little point as well. This is a good one. It's really effective when we're talking about partnerships here and like husbands and wives, because, you know, people say to me, but my husband wants something different to me. How's that going to work on a vision board? Good point. Really good point. Because, you know, we can't confuse the universe either, because if we're asking, your husband wants one house and you want another, or vice versa, well, there's been, you know, a little bit of confusion reigns, or be careful because you might end up getting both your houses separately. I don't know what that is. But basically, when you're constructing a vision board, I always talk about a yours, mine and ours. And this is only a little bit of a guide. It's not something that's set in concrete, but you might like to say to yourself, well, you know what, I'd like to create a vision board for me. And darling, you can create a vision board for you. And if you like, we can create one together. So if, you know, in a relationship, there's nothing wrong with, you know, creating it. This is what we dream to do. We'd like to build this house. We'd like to travel the world. We'd like to build an orphanage in India. Whatever we'd like to do, that's the we board. And then there's the I board and the your board. So there's mine. That's my vision board and that's your vision board, honey. And you might not need to do separate ones. You don't have to. But I'm just trying to give you a little bit of a guide, because obviously, even if we are in a relationship, we've got our little things that we'd like to achieve for ourselves, and there's nothing wrong with doing that. So just be mindful of that, because again, the universe is just waiting for your direction. One thing I'm huge on, and I mentioned it a moment ago, I just sort of made reference to it a little while ago, is the importance of giving the universe direction. The universe, see, this is where people think the universe pulls the strings and we're just the puppets that react to what happens to us in our life. Absolute rubbish. The universe is only responding to our energy. So the energy we put out is the energy that is going to come back. So the thought process and the visualization process is incredible. I cannot emphasize the importance of visualization. Vision boards are great, but to me, that's just the vision that we remind ourselves with on a daily basis. But let's say, for example, that it is a beautiful new sports car that you want, as a hypothetic here. That's great to have a picture of the sports car on your vision board, but close your eyes and just envision the feeling, the smell of the leather, the feel of changing the gears and the wind in your hair as you've got the top down and whizzing around the beaches, whatever that is. That is such powerful, powerful stuff. But of course, visualization is another thing altogether. We don't really have time for that today. But I'll share a little bit about the vision board that I... Well, in fact, I did two vision boards back in 2009. It was in 2009 when I did these vision boards. And I know some of you beautiful souls that are watching this have perhaps seen my story. But, you know, for the benefit of those that haven't, I'm going to share it with you now. Because I'll tell you what, it really blows me away to see how powerful this is. Now, I did two vision boards. And I must tell you, here's the crazy thing. We have to learn to get out of the road of ourselves. We've got to get out of the road. Just get out of the road of you. Just tell the universe what you want and then get the hell out of the road so the universe can bring it through for you. Really powerful stuff. Now, the vision board that I did here, I actually did this vision board in August 2009. I was going through a pretty rough time in my life back then, as many of you know. And I'd actually come to a point where I had virtually lost everything and went through a pretty rough trot, losing all of my money, all of my material possessions, and it was a pretty crappy time in my life. But you know what? Looking back retrospectively, it was one of the most powerful lessons that I went through in my life, and something that I don't hold any regrets for going through now. Of course, when there's a rainstorm and there's a hailstorm ensuing, it's very, very difficult to think and imagine that there's a blue sky sunny day that will prevail and will come out at the end of it. But all storms do pass, and that was a storm that I had to go through to bring me to where I am. But I remember that when the chips were down, I think I had something like the sum total of $37 left in my wallet at the time, and that was it. I had no money left. And what I did then was, with the last few bucks I had in my pocket, I remember thinking to myself, you know, Davo, you need to get your vision down. You've got to get a picture together. Get a picture together and put some stuff down on a vision board so that you can at least try and rebuild your life. Because back then, I had no job, I had no business. I wasn't known as the flower man. I wasn't conducting any psychic readings back then. I was just, picking up the shrapnel of the life that had collapsed and into a bunch of sticks around me here. But anyway, what happened then was that I put two vision boards together, and I'll just give you an idea of what they are. Now, that one there you can see. That one says August 2009. You can see the old blue tack on there. It's pretty old and tatty, and it was on the board. It's all fallen to bits now because it's pretty old, and it's all bitsy-piecy now. But this is really powerful. Of course, I know most of you, if not all of you, realise that I am a gay man. And I decided that when I put my board together, I thought I'd like to create a couple of boards, one for my business, one for my work and what have you, and I'll do one for a nice new partner. This will really make you laugh. I put this board together, and it's quite a big one. And anyway, you can see it all there. Do, 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 do. It's quite a big board. That one's all fallen down. And I just thought I'll put a nice vision board together. Now, when I put this vision board together, I put a whole series of, you know, guys on there and nice personalities and little sayings, you know, as we normally do. We're happy together, a great long life, and, finally found love and all those sorts of things. And when I put the board together, I thought to myself, my God, I'd better really find out, I'd better to tell the universe where I'd like to live and what I'd like to do. So what I did was I thought, I'm really over the houses now. I've had, you know, I had a beautiful family and before I got divorced. And I'd like to, instead of buying a house, I think I'd like a really nice apartment. So I remember going down to the newsagent and buying a magazine that had homes and photos of apartments and things in it. And here's the crazy thing. I found the picture of my dream apartment and I put it up in the top left-hand corner there. And there you can see it. And all I had was the word penthouse. I just put the word penthouse in there. But as you will see, there was no dates on there. August 2009, I didn't know how I was going to get this apartment. I've got to be very honest with you guys. When I put this up there, I laughed because I had 30-odd bucks left in my wallet after all this time. And when I put that up there, I thought, how the hell am I going to get this apartment? Am I going to win lotto, or do I have to meet a rich millionaire who's going to, you know, buy the house, or maybe that's his house and we move in together? But I put it up there and all I had was the word penthouse and that was it. Now, that was in August 2009, and I've got to tell you, the universe works in crazy ways, because knowing that I was flat stone broke, I actually put it up there. I had that on my bedroom wall for about a year, this vision board. And then I took the vision board down because I moved house. And after that, I had to go. I lived in two other places before I got the place that I've got now. And they were too small for me to put any of these big board pieces up. So this was actually tucked away and it was gathering dust. It was in a storage shed and it was just gathering dust. And honestly, over 5 years, I had forgotten completely what I had put down on the vision board. It had been so long since I'd done it. And here's where the magic works, guys. Here's where the magic works. When you put your vision board down, it doesn't mean that you have to look at it every single day. Every now and again, you glance at it. And then even when I took it away and put it into storage, the magic was still at work. So I'll tell you what happened next. Let's fast forward to Australia Day 2015. I had met a client, a lady who came to me for a reading back in, she came to me in September 2014, and we, to cut a very long story short, we clicked, we hit it off, and she said at the end of it, she said, hey, look, you know, we should catch up and have a coffee one day. I said, yeah. You know, so it took us quite a few months to get that together because we were both very, very busy people. Anyway, long story short, she invited me over to her place that I'd never seen before on Australia Day 2015. And to my absolute shock and disbelief, when I got to Vicky's place that morning on Australia Day, it was a beautiful, beautiful sunny day, and I'd never been to her place. And when I walked in, I thought, my God, this is such a stunning apartment, such a beautiful, beautiful apartment. And anyway, I got there at 10 o'clock in the morning, and over lunch, she said to me, where would you like to live, Dave? What would you like to do? And, you know, just a bit of a general chit-chat about everything. Now, Vicky is a financial planner and advisor and very qualified in the field of real estate and investing and what have you, and, you know, a very, very well-to-do lady. Anyway, the long story short was I said, Vicky, I'd love to have an apartment. I'd love to buy an apartment one day. And she said, oh, good. Well, you know, what sort of apartment? I said, actually, honey, one like this would be great. And she said, well, you can buy this one if you want. And I said, what? So again, to cut a long story short, I said, honey, I'm not in a position to buy something like this. I don't know how the hell I'm going to afford something like this. And she laughed. She said, look, just throw some figures at me and I'll crunch some numbers for you. The long story short, we sat down over lunch and she just crunched all the figures out. She said, you have no idea how much you can afford this house. So this apartment. And so what I'm trying to say is it all came together in the most unexpected way. And without going into further details, there's a huge story attached to this, which will be in my book when I get it out there. But you'll be quite amazed to see what happened. The long story short, that afternoon, I actually purchased that property. I didn't realize how I was able to purchase it. Vicky was able to get some finances together to assist me a vendor finance to get me started, which I did. And of course, now I've got the whole mortgage set up through traditional sources. What I'm trying to say is, guys, that the apartment came to me. I didn't go to it. I haven't got the photo here, unfortunately. I don't have it here with me because I've got it at home. But I took a photo of my apartment on that very, very day, Australia Day 2015. And the shocking thing is, amazingly, the photo that I took is virtually identical to this. The blue in the background is the same colour blue. The shape of the windows is exactly the same. You don't know whether you can see it, but you can just see it here if your glare doesn't get it. In the photo here, there are Versace mats on the floor, and there's a white leather lounge, and there's a mirror behind. If you've been to my apartment, you'll see that there are Versace mats on the floor, there's a white leather lounge, and there's a mirror behind. Now, I bought my apartment fully furnished, as is, so the Versace mats and the white leather lounge were already there. So I didn't buy them to match this up. It was already there. Over here, you can't see it here because it's not that clear, but there's a balcony, a canal, and an ocean front. Well, my apartment has a balcony overlooking a canal, and I look down onto the beach from my office. So everything in here, bar the fireplace, is exactly what I have today. I mean, who needs a fireplace in Queensland? But what I'm saying is that what I put on there was so powerful. Now, here's another little trick to remember. I had one apartment on there, and that's what's come to pass. And yet over here, I had about 12 men, 12 guys, all different sorts of men. Blah, 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 as you can see. And the universe has gone, Dave, what the hell? You want 12 men? I don't think so. So what the adage that I had was, well, I like this guy's looks and I like this guy's personality and this guy's this and this guy's that. But one thing that I think is really powerful with this here, I realize now the universe didn't bring me my beautiful man. Do you know why? Because I had 12 men on the board, for God's sake. The universe was confused and saying, Dave, how many men do you want? I was like, far out, just one. So I've kept this board just to show where, oh my God, look at that. Even got a cheeky butt. Isn't that interesting? Who doesn't like a nice butt? Anyway, and there's some nice guys on there as well, fitness and health and everything else. So I got that. But then now I've updated it. Because, and I don't mean this to be all about men or gay things or other, but it's just the fact that it's where I'm at now, because I've achieved my beautiful apartment. I've got my apartment in order. Everything's coming together. And I'm actually going to talk about partners and partnerships, because I know this will apply to some of you in the sense that some of you are looking for a lovely new partner. And I'm looking for a lovely new partner as well. Of course, that would be nice. And the crazy thing is, I've met a couple of nice guys along the way, but just have not found the right person for me yet. But here's the crazy thing. I thought, I've got to get very clear, very specific, and very detailed about what it is that I would like to do, who I'd like to attract. So I've actually created a brand new, what I call a partner board for one partner only. And that's what I've got. There we go. My gorgeous, hot, gay life partner. I don't know who this guy is, but I thought, oh, look, just a nice, mature man who's been to Thailand to get his teeth done too. You can see that. See the big smile he's got? So at least our teeth match. And then up here, I've just got, we love each other. And that's it. It's very simple and concise. So that's what I've got for me. And you can put whatever you want about your partner. And we'll just, as I said, we're talking about partners now. So how are we going for time? Perfect timing. Perfect timing. We're about halfway through. Because I wanted to give about 30 minutes on vision boarding and 30 minutes on the list writing. So you've heard a little bit about the vision boarding for me, and you can, as I said, you can have 3, 4, 5, 6 vision boards. But can I tell you guys, can I tell you something, please? This is such valuable stuff. Universe loves detail. They love detail, detail, detail. I've got to be honest, don't put things, you can put on the vision board whatever you want, but never ask for things like happiness. I want happiness. Universe doesn't bring you happiness, guys. It doesn't bring you happiness. It doesn't bring you joy. You can say, I live a very happy life, but you can't ask for happiness. You can't ask for joy, but you can say, I live a very joyful life now. So always have it as the now. Always have it in the present. Never use words like I wish, I want, I dream, I hope, or desire, or one day. Because it's all future stuff. Never get immersed in the future stuff. It's, in fact, when you look at your vision board, it's like, it's almost, I call it, you can almost call it a thank you board. It's like, thank you for bringing this stuff in. Thank you, guys. Thank you, God. Thank you, universe. Thank you, Jehovah, Buddha, whatever you want, whatever deity you wish to acknowledge. You can bring it in as a, well, thank you for this beautiful person. I give thanks to my beautiful partner every day, but I haven't met him yet. I'm not worried about that because, you know what, divine timing will bring it in. I always have a bit of a joke and I laugh and say, and people say, have you met your partner yet? No, I haven't. He's on the train. He's on his way. But there's just been a delay of the train, so he's just caught up on the train. God, won't I laugh if he does work in the bloody train network? Who knows? Stranger things have happened. Anyway, so that's a little bit about vision boarding. I haven't seen any of your comments yet, so I don't know whether there's any... there we go. Da-da-da-da. Okay, that's good. Hello, mate. There's Romy. There's Leanne. Hi, guys. Beautiful to see you. Now we're going to go into a little bit about vision boarding. About list writing. Now, this is the nitty. I call this the engine room, like the nitty gritty, getting into the details. And to me personally, I think it's a really, really powerful way to bring in your dreams and your wishes in a more grander and a more powerful way. And I've used the example of bringing in a beautiful partner, because to me, I'm only using that as a snapshot. I mean, there's so many things that you can talk about, but I thought, well, I'll bring my vision board up to show you how I've constructed a vision board for my partner, as in simple, just a nice photo of someone nice and just with a simple word here, my gorgeous gay hot life partner photo, we love each other. But in the list writing, I have got explicit detail about who this person is and the type of relationship that we have. And it's a really powerful thing to do. Now, I mean, I've got a huge big folder, like a big art book here. You don't have to have a big art book like this. That's just typical me. I just have everything sort of bigger and grander. You can actually have just a small book like that. You might even want to have a little flip, one of those little notebook things. You can have a notebook. It doesn't really matter. Like, the universe doesn't look at what it is. But just remember, one thing, guys, the universe loves room. They love space. They like you to, you've got to have room to create. If you write things in cramped little books and back to back and it doesn't show, space and room and creation, abundance, that's the word I'm looking for. It doesn't show, like as if you're saying, I haven't got abundance. You have got such an abundant energy to be able to share and to be able to bring through. So you can just use, I mean, these books, they're like, you know, you can get those for like 80 cents down at Kmart. It doesn't really matter. But one thing I'd say to you, just get a lined book like that with all the lines in it, and get you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 books. I actually have a book for every subject that I want to write a list about. I actually wrote a list for my apartment as well as doing the vision board back in July 2013. And it was only probably 4 or 5 pages long in one of these books. And it explained explicitly what my apartment was, the smell that I had in it, the candles that I burn, the music that I play, the people that I entertain. And you know what? That has exactly come to the pass, to the letter, to the absolute letter. And it blows me away because I think, my God, I created it with a picture, but then I call it adding fuel to the fire by writing a list down as well. And it really just fired it up in my head. It was just magnificent. So that's what that is there. Now, with your list, when you write your list, there's a few little protocols that I follow. And again, I only follow these because they are things that I've been taught along the way from a couple that I learned an awful lot from by the name of Tom and Penelope Pawley, who wrote the book A Rich Beyond My Wildest Dreams, I Am, I Am, I Am. And in their book, in their story, it goes into explaining how they were in their early mid-50s and went through the worst times and lost everything. And they were shown a process to bring this vision, the list writing together, and they wrote their lists. And a lady, a crazy lady by the name of Marilyn, who was a clairvoyant medium psychic, the same as me, over in California, sat down with her one day and they said, "This is how you got to." She said, "You got to construct a list. You got to show the universe direction." So this is the process that they use, and it's something that I've adopted. And I've got to say, guys, it works to the letter. If you have been following me on Facebook over the last year or two, you can see some of the crazy things that are happening for me in my life now, and what I'm bringing in, what I'm creating, the wonderful opportunities that are just coming about because I've had all this written down. I wrote this down 2, 3, 4 years ago. All my teeth that I had done in Thailand, I wrote this on a list, and you know where I got it done. There was a gentleman that I met, Andrew Constable. I don't know whether Andrew is watching, but I think Belinda might be, his beautiful sister. Hi, darling. I know Andrew went over to Thailand and had all his teeth done. And when I asked where he had it done, I wrote it on the list and said, "This is where I'd like to have my teeth done." Guess what? That's exactly where I ended up. But again, the person that instigated the whole thing for me to get my teeth done actually came to me for a reading. It's crazy how it works, guys. As I said before earlier in the piece, we've just got to learn to get out of the road of ourselves and let the universe work its magic. Let the universe bring to you its magic because it's just, it's really crazy good. Anyway, back to the list. So on here, I've just got a list here which simply says, "My beautiful gay partner." Okay, that's it. That's on the first page. On the second page, at the back, on the back of it, it's got "All this by divine right, divine intervention, divine timing, and with good for all concerned." That's what I've got written on there because it's a beautiful, it's almost like an acknowledgement to the universe that everything is divine right, which means you're right to create that which you get at birth. So, you know, I always say that from at the moment we are born, we are divine. It is within our divine right to claim that is rightly ours and divinely meant for us here. Divine intervention, divine timing, and with good for all concerned, which means that this is a good outcome for everyone. It's not just for you. It's not just about me. It's like, this is good for everyone. It's good for me, but it's good for everybody else. Anyway, so then the next page we leave blank. And here's where the magic starts. I have got written here my list. Okay, so I've just got written here my list. You always put my list at the top of your list, and I've got that there. And I've just got "Dear Divine Intelligence," or you can write "Dear Divine Creator," or you can write "Dear God" or "Dear Universe." It doesn't really matter, but I just use, you know, "Dear Divine Intelligence." Now, on that first page, I've actually got just written down here, it's just a snapshot story of my partner and I's life together, just what our life is like. Just to give you an example, like, "Thank you, thank you, thank you for my loving, caring, romantic relationship. my partner truly makes my heart sing. He's everything more than I could ever dreamed of. Thank you. So there's a little bit of a, and it goes on from there. And I won't bore you with all the details, but that's just what I call a snapshot of that first page. Now, this is where it gets interesting, because over the page, remember, when you turn the page, blank. Never, never, never write on the left-hand side once you've started to write your list. The only place where you write on this on the left-hand page is just after the first page. You put that on the left, that you're what I call the universal exclamation. But after that, you only ever write on the right-hand side of the page. Always leave the left side blank. The reason being, it shows abundance. You're showing the universe you've got tons of room, you've got tons of space, and you don't want to cram it all up. You don't want to cram your whole life, your whole written life, all on one page there. Some people think, oh, I'll write it down, and I'll screw. And yet you've got a huge, whole big book to create with. But then why just put it all on one page? Because it's actually an expression of lack. It's a lack, sort of lack thinking. Anyway, so after that, we then move over here. And once again, we start off with my list. And again, it says, Dear Divine Intelligence. And I write here, I am so happy, thrilled, and profoundly grateful that my beautiful gay partner, dash, is. And I've got all these, just an asterisk down here. And between, and there's just bullet point form. When you write your list, guys, don't write big, long, waffly paragraphs and what have you. It's too much for the universe to absorb. So what you need to do is just put things in a bullet point form. Let's say, for example, you'd like a new Subaru. When you don't put down, well, I want a new, I thank you for my new Subaru. It's black and it's got air conditioning, it's got stereo, it's got mag wheels, blah, blah, blah. Don't do all that in one paragraph. You write down, thank you for my new Subaru. It is a WRX, blah. It all in bullet point form. It is black. Blah. It has a top stereo in it. It has air conditioning. And when you do that, leave a space between each line that you've written here. Because again, it shows room and it shows space. That's really important to do. So always do that. Now, here's the other thing too. When you're writing out your list, guys, I have got, I know this might, you might think, bloody hell, you've got such a lot to ask of a partner. Well, yes, I have. And you know why? It's not because I'm fussy. Well, of course I'm fussy, but it's not that I want this and I want that. I want to show the universe detail. The universe loves detail. They love you going into explicit detail. Don't just write down there, I just want to meet a nice man. Oh my God, the universe says, what do you mean by a nice man? Or if it's a lady you're looking for, I just want to meet a nice lady. Well, tell us about that. Oh, she's got dark hair. Oh my God, come on, let's be more specific. So we get into character traits. We get into quirky little things. And I've got to tell you too, even throw in some quirky little things like, you might say, for example, oh my God, my beautiful new partner is mad on the Carpenters. that singing duo from the 1970s who were so big back then. You might think, what the hell? Or you might say, someone has a real thing about Scottish haggis or something like that. I don't know. It's something really quirky that you can put on your list there to make it really, really meaty. It's really extraordinary. Anyway, now on my list here for my partner, here's the crazy thing. I'm not going to show it all, but you, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, there we are, 10 pages all up. 10 pages of requests to the universe about all the traits that I'm looking for in my beautiful new partner. But it's not just about him. I've also got written down about us, about the life we had together, the laughs we had together, the things that we shared together. It's not just about, well, he's got to be this, he's got to be this tall, got to this color hair, blah, 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 blah. It's a whole snapshot of my whole entire life. And every time I look through that, it's like, wow, that's just really great. He loves weekend escapes with me. He loves campfires. I've got all that written down here. So it's just about the things that we experience together as well. And here's another little tip, really important. When you get to the end up here, let's say at the end of the 9 pages, there we go. So on the last page, okay, there's the last page. The next page is blank. Now, if you've got a big book like this, or if you've got even the exercise book that I showed you before, if you've written down everything, say 10 pages, and you've still got a whole book left, if you would like to then start writing about your dream home or your dream holiday or your dream business or career, once you've got the partner out of the road, if you're looking for a partner or whatever it is, never write on the next page. Always leave 6 blank pages between each subject. Reason being, you're showing the universe once again, you're still leading 6 pages of potentiality and possibility, meaning that you might think, oh my God, I forgot to write this down about a partner. I forgot to write down that they don't smoke. Well, if you've already started to write the next thing on there, you've got no more room left to create. Do you follow what I mean? Because that way it's like, oh, I'll start off, time to start off a new page. Oh no, I'm a real coffee aficionado. I only like X brand of coffee. I only drink Starbucks or Gloria Jean's or whatever it is. Well, you can write that on the next page. But if you've filled up the first 10 pages and you've already started into the next section, you've got nowhere left. So it's another little message to the universe to leave space to create before you start creating your next thing. And again, do be careful what you wish for, and you've got to be so specific, and I'll tell you exactly why. When we talk about specifics, I actually created a list for a partner back in, oh my goodness, probably 3 years ago now, when I wrote one down, and I tell you what, be careful what you wish for and what you write down, because bingo, you will get it. I think it might have been about maybe 4 or 5 pages long, for a nice partner. And guess what I wrote at the bottom? I went to so much trouble to construct this, exactly like you've seen here. That's pretty much how I did it. But when I wrote at the bottom, I wrote down, thank you, universe, for bringing me this beautiful man. I'm so happy and grateful. We met at the most unexpected time, at the most unexpected place, at the most unexpected event. I wrote that down because I wanted to make it really edgy and a little bit, oh, that's a little bit interesting and a little bit, a little bit of a surprise, I guess. I love the surprise element. Well, my God, I wrote that on the Friday night, and the guy that was on that list, I met him 8 days later, and it blew me away because I honestly thought I had met this gorgeous, gorgeous man. And the crazy thing was, we met, we connected, we clicked, and we're still very dear friends to this day, although we've never had a relationship of any sort, but we're great mates. But you know what? I looked at my list and I thought, oh, he's everything on that list, virtually everything on that list. Something's not connecting, something's not right. Bingo, bing, light bulb moment. Guess what? I went through that list and read it, and at the end of it, bloody had written down at the bottom, I said, thank you for my beautiful man, I'm so happy and grateful. I didn't write, thank you for my beautiful gay partner. So our universe said, well, there's your man, and he's gay, and he's single, he's everything you requested on the list. You've got exactly what you want. Why would you get anything different? Oh my God. So you've got to really be specific about what it is that you so desire. And I've got to tell you a really funny story. I love stories, as if you didn't know. I love stories, and I love this story because it's such a beautiful story that tells you a lot about the power of writing out your lists. I think it was maybe a year or two ago, I had a lady come and see me one day for a reading, and at the end of the reading we got chatting about lists and things and talking about all these sorts of things. And she said to me at the end of it, I said to her, darling, have you ever written a list to create anything in your life? And she said, David, that's how I met my husband. I said, wow, what did you write? Tell me, I'd be interested to know. She said, you're going to be quite interested, you know, because it was something fairly, fairly simple. It wasn't really too much. She had a little notebook, spiral notebook, a little notepad thing. And she said, one day, she said, I sat down and thought, you know, I've been on my own for a couple of years. She had a couple of little kids. She'd been through a bit of a rough time with a divorce. And she said, I think I'm ready to meet someone. She'd been on her own for maybe a few years. So she wrote down a list. She wrote down a few things there. And she said, it was just ordinary, straightforward stuff like, oh, you know, blah, 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 blah. You know, he treats me nice. Blah, blah, boom, he's this and he's that. She said, it just felt nice. And she said, I put the pen down. And all of a sudden, my pen was picked up by an unseen force, and she said, on the bottom I wrote, on our second date, he will tell me a joke about pirates. And she thought, what the bloody hell is all that about? That's crazy. She said, where did that come from? She said, I looked up to the universe and said, what'd you give me that for? That's bizarre. And she said, again, I picked up the pen and went to scribble it out, and it wouldn't let me. She said, I just couldn't scribble it out. She said, oh, that's just so random, it's so crazy. Anyway, so she tossed the notebook in the drawer and forgot all about it. There it remained for 6 months. 6 months later, a girlfriend of hers rang one day and said, hey, listen, you know, Carol's got a barbecue at her place tomorrow night, do you want to come? She instantly said, no, I don't want to go, because she said it's Sunday night, it's school night, Monday morning, got to get the kids up, so no, can't have a late night. Her girlfriend wouldn't let up. She said, you've got to come. And she said, look, I'll even come around, I'll pick you up, so you can have a few little drinkies, and promise to have you home by 9 o'clock. Deal? And her friend said, okay, all right. So she said to me, David, I went. She said, I was sort of half-hearted about it, didn't really want to go. And she said, I was in the kitchen fiddling around with their girlfriend. And she said, I looked out through the kitchen window, and she said, there was a group of people out around the barbecue and standing out in the backyard. And she said, Captain Fabulous was standing by the pool, out by the pool fence. And she said to her girlfriend, my God, who's that? God, he's a little bit easy on the eye, a bit hot. And she said, oh, that's a friend of ours from down the road. And, you know, he's divorced as well. He's got a couple of kids, and we've just invited him up. So she said, the long and the short of it, David, she said, we actually caught up, and we absolutely clicked through the course of the night. We clicked, and she said, he was the one who said at 9 o'clock, he went, oh, darling, he says, 9 o'clock. He said, I'm so sorry. He said, I've got to go, because I've got to get the kids to bed. She said, oh, God, I've promised my girlfriend. The girlfriend's standing there saying, darling, it's 9 o'clock. So she said, yeah. But beautifully, he said, listen, we're getting on so well. He said, this is just going so well. He said, are you up for a dinner date next week? And she said, oh my God, are you serious? She said, I'd love to go on a dinner date. So he said, well, how about we go out for dinner next week and keep up the conversation? This is going really well. So he said, I'll come and pick you up. So we did that. Over dinner, they discovered that they absolutely loved movies. And over that time, he just said, well, look, he said, there's such and such a movies coming out next week. Why don't we go to the movies and do a movie dinner date next week? Movie date. She said, oh my God, fantastic. And she said, David, that night my life changed, because we went to the movies, and she said, when we finished the movies, he said, hey, before we go, why don't we zip down to Max Brenner's and have a coffee or hot chocolate down there, and then we'll go. She said, fine. She said, David, what happened next made me just chill to the bone. He went over to order a coffee. He came back with a table number, put it down on the table, and he said, while we're waiting for the coffee to come, I've just got to tell you this joke about pirates. It was their second date. It was exactly what she had written on her list 6 months prior. And up until that very minute, she had completely forgotten she'd written the list or what she'd written on it. And it was only then, like a sledgehammer, she suddenly recalled all the things she'd written down was this guy to a T. And she said, we've now been married for 4 very, very happy years. So she said, I instantly knew that I'd met my husband as soon as those words left his mouth. It's like, oh my God. So she did get exactly what she wished for. So there you have it, my dear friends. We're going to wrap up, and maybe I can have a little bit of a chat to you if some of you have got questions. I know lots of comments have been coming up, and my beautiful Louise here has been very diligently checking everything out. So how are we going, Lulu?
Let's have a look. I think there was something down below. I'm not quite sure what this is referring to, but it must have been something you comment on about... something about, so does it have to be physical? So do you remember anything that
yep.
might have been...
Yep, yep. Okay, Trevor, how are you, mate? Trevor's over in Singapore. Well, I think you're in Singapore. Every time I go on Facebook, you're in Chicago or Singapore or Hong Kong. Wherever you are in the world, mate, hi. Great to see you, buddy. I know you do live in Singapore. There's a question you've come up here, mate, and said, does it have to be physical? A goal does not have to be a physical goal. It can be an experience. And for example, that's travel. You know, travel is not a physical thing as in acquiring something physically, but to jump on a plane and go around the world and come back. When you come back, you've still got the same suitcase, but you've gone away and had a world of experiences. So it doesn't have to be a physical thing. That if that's what you're referring to, and by note of your question here, I'd say that would be the case, mate. So no, it's a vision board or even writing your list doesn't have to be about physical things. And honestly, even a you know, when you're creating a relationship, you know, you're well, of course, you know, you're manifesting a physical person, but you're manifesting an experience as well. So vision boarding and list writing is about creating many, many things, but not just on the physical. Because remember, at the end of the day, everything's just energy anyway. So that's how it is.
So Gillian Brand was saying, I want abundance, but it's not happening. So is there something that she could be doing wrong, or she could be doing something better? Or
okay, you know? Honey, this is who?
This is Gillian Brand.
Gillian Brand.
Yeah.
Gillian, how are you, darling? Another question from you, and the question was your...
She wants abundance, but it's just not happening.
Okay.
So is there something going
darling, on? Your question is you're wanting abundance, but it's not happening. Sweetheart, to be honest, I'm not quite sure what you mean by that, because it's a very erroneous question you've asked in the sense of you're wanting abundance. First and foremost, honey, please don't want. Never want. If you want for something, if you're wanting, you'll never get. This is a difficult one, and this is a very common place where people struggle, because it's all about, but I want more wealth, I want abundance, and I want a relationship, I want. But if we run around and think that we want something all the time, we'll never get it, you will never get it. We've got to start feeling, first and foremost, the first port of call for you, my darling, to bring more abundance is to feel abundant, even when you don't have it. It's a tough one, I know, but you have to. And trust me, I've been there. I've been there 8 years ago. And to feel good about who you are and about what you are is what it's all about. I think you were asking about what do I have to do? What steps do I have to take to do that? The first step is feel good about you now. Feel good about your abundance now. Because if you look hard enough, honey, there will be abundance in some way, shape, or form in your life, hopefully. It could be abundant health. You might be, when you use the word abundance, honey, you might be referring to to wealth or to money. Because to me, the word abundance is everything. Wealth is a separate word to abundance. Because we can, when one is abundant, we have abundant health, abundant happiness, abundance of friendships, abundance of money, abundance of opportunity, and abundance of joy, and so forth. So abundance it's all encompassing, it's a big word, and it's not just about money as such. So to want abundance is almost like trying to blow the clouds away just with your own breath. It can't happen, honey. You can't just wish for abundance. Abundance, you got to, once again, the universe, you've seen it here, honey, the universe is asking for specifics. So start writing down, and I don't know whether you've actually written a list, honey, or whether you've done a vision board, because I know your question is about, I'm wanting more abundance, but it's not happening. So I'm hoping, if you haven't done a vision board or haven't done a list yet, this is something else that's going to help you start unblocking that, because you've got to get it out of here and get it onto, first and foremost, some photos onto a vision board and some writings down onto your list there.
We also have a couple of people actually asking, do you actually have to write your list down on paper, or can it be done on the computer?
No, that's fine. You can write it down on the computer if you wish. It doesn't have to be handwritten. What I'd probably do, I've never written it on a computer, and I don't believe there's any... protocol as far as that's concerned. What I'd probably do is, if you're going to write it on the computer, type it all up on the computer and print it out and maybe put it into a book or something. Get a book with like plastic sleeves in it so you can slot it in, or maybe put it all together and clonk it together in a spiral pad or something rather. So I know some people aren't big on writing things down, which is fair enough, and some people much prefer to do things typed down. So if you're going to put it on the computer, guys, I'd suggest put it on the computer. I mean, you've got it on your hard drive anyway, a copy of it, but print it out and also put it into a book. Another little tip.
Krista is asking, what does it mean when the pen decided what to write? Automatic writing, what is that? What does it mean when the pen decided what to write? Okay. Automatic writing, what's that?
Okay, automatic writing. Good point too, Krista. Basically, the lady just said, I just had this thought. It came into my head. She said, I'd consciously written down her list about this lovely man. And she said, she put the pen down. She said, all of a sudden, the pen that just picked up, and she wrote down, on the second date, he will tell me a joke about pirates. She said it was just so random. So to put that into a perspective that I hope you can understand, honey, it's almost like she was divinely guided, or divinely, it's the same as the way that I work. Clairvoyancy, psychic work, mediumship, it's all the same. It's just connecting to the divine, and the divine energy can work through every single person. I want you to get out of your head that, you know, people like me are the only people that can connect to the divine to get their guidance. Rubbish. Everyone can do this, because it's a divine energy that we can connect to. So it's almost like her higher self, her higher energy, was the thing that picked up that pen and just wrote out what it is. And she looked at it and consciously thought, what the hell did I write that down for? But you know what? It came out for a reason, and maybe it was the divine that was really starting to, work through her. So whatever that is, it was just something that, that's the way that it works. That's the best way that I can describe it. Automatic writing is when somebody picks up a pen and just things just channel through. It's the same as when I do a reading, or when anyone does a reading and you channel the information through, it just comes from a higher source. So I call it higher source guidance, higher source energy that comes through and helps us. So I hope that helps you, honey.
We have another question from Brandy Jensen.
Brandy, my darling, how are you?
Can you ever ask the universe for too much?
Never. Oh, my God, no. No, because the universe will say, what's too much? What's too much? How can we ask for too much? We can never ask for too much. It comes back to what I said before about people saying, God, I don't want to be greedy. I can't be greedy. I don't want to, you know. The biggest challenge every one of us faces, almost every person, myself included, is the fact that we've got to challenge our own beliefs. We've got to challenge our own thoughts as to what is divinely ours, or is that too much? Because you see, the trouble is we've all been conditioned from the moment we're born. Even if we have the most loving, caring, nurturing, wonderfully open, supportive parents, there is a level of, oh, well, you know, you can't go beyond that. And you know what? This is what schooling teaches us as well. The schooling system, the education system, doesn't really, teach kids to, you know, limitless expansion and what we can, you know, what our wildest dreams are. None of us know that. So you can never ask for too much, honey. The challenge is to put something down on your vision board and to write something down on your list that's bigger than you could ever imagine. Bigger. If you want to. You don't have to. But it's like, oh, but, you know, in my wildest dreams, I wouldn't mind, blah, 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 but I don't know how that could happen. Well, you know what? Write it down, put it on your vision board, wait for it to happen.
And I guess this may carry on from what you were just saying, but Rachel has made a comment saying, do you think you could do a list about purely accumulating money? Could the list be about a perfect relationship with money?
Okay. Good question. My God, Rachel, thank you so much for asking that question. I'm so glad the money question came up. This is where so many people get unstuck. Rule number one when you are writing your list, guys, never, 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 never ask for money. Never ask for money. Never ask the universe for money. Because people say, how many times have you heard people say, God, if I just won lotto, God, if I just had $500,000, God, if I had $10 million, it would change my life. Universe says, what a load of trollop. And I'll tell you why. If you ask the universe for money, you're just asking for energy. It's almost like, it's no different to, can the universe make me happy? You know, you can ask the universe for happiness or you can ask for money, same thing, it's all energy. You create your happiness and you create your wealth. And I'll explain how that is. If you ask for money, you're asking for nothing. But what you need to do, I'll put it to you this way. Let's say you wanted $1 million. What do you want $1 million for? Because if you just want to have $1 million to sit in the bank just to feel good, forget it. It's just not going to happen. But if you need that $1 million because half of it you want to donate to a charity, you want to build a house build a school over in India, you want to do some charity work, or you might want to buy $1 million Ferrari. You've got to show the universe and explain to the universe what you want the money for. That's the whole point of writing a list. But if you write down a list of just saying, universe, I just want $10 million in the bank. That's all I want. I will guarantee it'll never work. It will never work. You never ask for money, but what you've got to show the universe is what you want the money for. See, this is exactly how I got my apartment. You see, I manifested my beautiful apartment I live in now by putting it on my vision board and writing a list for it. And guess what? The person turned up and the universe...
Oops, are we back?
We're back.
We froze for a little bit. Can you? Hopefully, we're all back and you can see us again. Sorry. maybe it's telling David to shut up.
why do I look like frozen? Anyway, midstream. That's right. Where was I up to?
I can't remember now.
Can't remember. God, I can't remember. Anyway, I was on a roll. But now I think that's it. What else?
We've got some excellent questions popping up. I mean, we've got to have to probably close it down shortly. But yep. There's a couple of questions being a bit similar,
yep,
in regards to how can we make this all happen faster? What about the time frame?
Right.
Can we set a date?
Okay, beautiful. Well, I don't know. Now, the people that are asking me about time frames and dates and when and how and, oh my God, can you ask it for it to be quicker? I don't know when you came into the conversation, because right from at the very beginning of our session today, I was explaining about divine timing, and everything that we do in our life, guys, is about divine timing. if you're someone who has witnessed my wonderful journey over the last couple of years and seeing how things are manifesting so amazingly well for me, I'm not attached to the time frame. I'm not attached to timing. When I did my vision board for my apartment, I didn't know whether I'd get that apartment in one day, one week, one year, or 10 years. I didn't have a clue. I didn't know how it was going to come. All I set was the intention. There's the intention, guys. I'm going to walk away and leave you with it. So as history shows, the apartment came to me 6 years after I put it down, after I put it on my vision board, 6 years. Now, some people might say, oh, as we sit here today, you might think, oh, God, have I got to wait 6 years for my next house or 6 years for that? Well, guess what? Where are you going to be in 6 years anyway? You're going to be wherever you are in 6 years. So just let it go and enjoy the process. So my all-round answer to the question about timing, you must understand everything is divine timing. By all means, if you want to put a date on it, put a date on it. But if it doesn't manifest by that date, don't toss your thing away and walk away, because universe will walk away as well. I can't emphasize enough about divine timing, and I'm only saying that because of my own experience and the way that I've been taught through this process as well. So good luck with that one.
We might just end with one question here, and then we'll talk about other things. So Mark has asked, can you ask the universe to help someone else like your mum?
Absolutely not, unfortunately. You cannot ask. That's a really good question, Mark. I'm sorry to say this, mate, but we cannot request assistance for another person, because the reason being, this beautiful universe of ours is governed by the law of free will, one of the many beautiful and intricate spiritual laws that we must understand how it works. So let's say, for example, that, you're asking, can you assist your beautiful mum? Now, I don't know in what way that is, because your mum may need assistance financially, she may need it emotionally, she might need it health-wise, she might be sick, I have no idea, and it doesn't really matter, because here's the point. Let's say, for example, that mum needs assistance in whatever area she's looking at. You know what? What you need to do, mate, is to sit down with your mum and say, mum, there's a powerful process here that I believe will work for you. Would you like to sit down and create a vision board, or would you like to write a list? So whatever scenario she's in, if she's going through a tough or difficult situation, we have to sit down with that person and share our knowledge the way that I'm sharing with you today. You can sit down and say, you can do it for you. So that's a really good point. So to wrap that up, we can never ask for someone else. Let's say, I've often had people say, but can I write some stuff down for my husband or my wife because they haven't got time? Forget it, not going to work, guys, because it breaches the law of free will. So by all means, with your partner, sit down and create a list or a vision board with your partner. In fact, it's a really fun thing to do. It's really fun to sit down there. Oh my God, look what's on my list, and look what's on our list. That's a really good thing to do. But you cannot, by law, spiritual law, you cannot sit down and create stuff. So you can't do a vision board or a list for you and for somebody else. It will never work.
So it's probably just about to ready to finish
Nearly
off
time,
now.
Guys. God, we've had a ball. Been loving talking to you and sharing my little bits and pieces. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. God, we shouldn't do this more than 5 times a week, should we? It's been an absolute pleasure to chat to you all, and I hope you've gleaned a few little, powerful things out of that can really assist you in some way, shape or form. So to that end, I'm just going to chat to you a little bit about what I do and how it all works. Correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Off you go. Just not a Seymour one.
Not a Seymour one.
A quick one.
Okay. couple of quick things. First and foremost, now, what date? March the
5th.
March the 5th. Sunday, March the 5th. I've actually got an event on up at Bungunya Manor. That's an afternoon event.
At Mount Tambourine.
What time do we kick off?
I think it's about 11 o'clock. You'll have nibblies and you'll be meeting guests on arrival,
mm-hmm.
Having chats to them about anything spirituality and things like that.
Yep.
And you'll have that beautiful violinist
yes,
playing
know,
as well.
Yes, I know,
so,
yes. We've got a beautiful violinist playing, and he'll be serenading us with the violin. He's absolutely spectacular to listen to. He'll be there. We'll have drinks and nibbles on arrival, which is just lovely. And then we're going to do some flower reading.
And you'll also be telling some stories.
Yes.
And If you haven't seen David before besides this, of course you can understand he can tell great stories. The stories that he can say and his experience in life is just absolutely amazing. I mean, I hear the stories over and over again, but, you know, each time he kind of puts a different spin on it and makes it even exciting. So even you might have heard the story for the past 5 years.
But it's just got better.
It has got better. He adds a little bit more to it. But no, it's really, really exciting to watch. Yes, it is. He gets very good at doing it. So it'll be a lovely time. So half of it will be flower readings, but then half of it will be storytelling. Also questions. You'll be able to ask questions for David and things like that. And it'll just go with the flow with what everyone will be feeling like at the event as well. And you'll sit down to a beautiful two-course lunch as well. So you've got a number of hours to have a chat to David. It's only for 40 people.
Very intimate.
So get your tickets. They're up for sale as well. I have been posting links in the actual event for this live feed as well as in the comments. So check that out, or private message Spiritual Events Directory, and they can forward you on some more information if you can't find them as well.
Great. In addition to that, I'm also doing... last year, I very successfully had a number of spiritual mentoring nights in my lovely apartment in Surfers Paradise. I will also be conducting those again from... When have we got some dates
yet? I'm just going in there now. My computer's a little bit slow, so
that's right.
Just bear with me and I
but
can
it is Saturday,
my...
honey.
Yes.
And it's hot.
I know.
Computer's a bit like me. So I'll be conducting some spiritual mentoring nights over a number of nights. So people can come along and they can join one night or they can join the whole four. And I'll be taking them on a little bit of journey of the soul and spirit, manifestation, covering a lot of the stuff that we've covered today, which is great.
Yep, so the workshops start. The first one will be on the 8th of May, learning and understanding the basic elements
of spiritual, of your
spiritual
soul. Yep.
And then, yeah, each month after that, there'll be workshops, as well as, of course, your champagne and flower evenings.
Yes.
Will be starting back up in March as well, so
beautiful.
Where you can go do that. And then you'll be travelling, of course, to Mackay, Perth.
Thailand.
Norfolk Island.
Norfolk Island, then I got the cruise, and then I've also got my mystery destination for my guest speaking.
Yes.
My corporate event. Woohoo! So I've got about 6 trips lined up between now and October, so it's pretty full on, and I'll be getting around. I think Perth, we've only got one date left. The rest of the Perth event is sold out, which is extraordinary, considering I've never been over there before, and all the new people over there are going to be... it's going to be wonderful to work with all the newbies over there. So anyway, there's a lot happening. The flower champagne nights, the flower reading party nights that I'm famous for, I guess. February is already completely booked out, which is just wonderful. March is starting to fill up, and it's going to be an extremely busy and prosperous year for all of us.
And then, of course, with your private flower readings as well, you can combine them with mentoring now as well. So that's new for this year.
Yeah, that's new for this year. That's it. So what I do, instead of doing a full 1 hour reading, I'm finding this is really, really popular with a lot of people. People can book in. You can either have a half an hour reading. So I do a 30-minute reading, which encompasses a flower reading and a card reading. So essentially you get 2 readings into one. And then so that's a half an hour. And then if you want, you can actually purchase an extra half an hour and receive some personal coaching from me in regard to, it can be anything from what we've covered today. If you'd like some guidance on your list writing or your vision boarding, please feel free to come along, because I'll show you all of the vision boards and the lists that I've got written down, just to show you. I mean, you've seen it here today, but it just shows you what it's done. And honestly, if you haven't been to my apartment before, you can come in and have a look at it. And I just simply say to people, when they walk in the door, it's like, this is what I created from a vision board and writing a list. I gave the universe direction. I directed my energy, my focus, and my dreams and my intention. And then I walked away and forgot all about it. Then I came up, tapped me on the shoulder. Hello, here I am. Amazing, amazing stuff.
So any further information about David, you can go to his Facebook page, which is David Law's Famous Flower Man. So just head to there. As I said, all the links should be in the comments below or under the event that was scheduled for this live Facebook feed. But I will say bye-bye and hand you over to the final farewell for lovely David.
Thank you, Lulu. Thank you. This lady is amazing. My life would be nothing without her. Actually, I should have stuck you on a vision board, shouldn't I?
I know. I'm surprised I'm not on there. Yeah.
Actually, I forgot to ask for the hairy chest. That's what I didn't get to. I should have put an assistant with a hairy chest, but look what I got.
Yeah.
Big boobs. Big boobs, you dog. That's funny. Okay. God, that's thrown me out. I've been there for so long. Guys, thank you for your beautiful time this afternoon. It's been a pleasure for me to work with you and to share some things. And look, you know, if one of you or all of you get something amazing out of it, fan-bloody-tastic. I'm really happy. All I want to say is that this works for everyone. And if there's something that's not working with you in your life, look, please feel free to book in a session with me and I'll try and help you in some way, shape or form. Because you know what, guys, this works for everyone. Universe doesn't, I said it earlier before, they don't pick and choose and say, lucky you, unlucky you, lucky you. It's not like that. This is just an energy. And when you align with the energy, it cannot help but work. It's no different to planting a seed in the ground. If you, as long as you water it, nurture it, fertilize it with sunshine, it by nature has to expand and grow into its completion. Anyway, so that's about it. Have a super, super Saturday. I've already done a flower reading party this afternoon. I'm here to have a quick coffee, a quick nibble, and another flower reading party tonight. So it's a back-to-backer today. So lots and lots of happy souls. Can't wait to get back into it all. Love and hugs to you all. Thank you for your time and attention. And good luck with creating and manifesting. And please, as time goes by, give me some feedback and let me know how it all goes for you. Take care. See you soon. Bye.